This is a Tesla Model X at the very high suspension setting. So what I thought about was just making a video showing you all the different height settings on the new 2018 models. There have been a couple for the launch release of the 2016 models, but there have been significant changes between those two vehicles, so let's see if they're any different. The Tesla Smart Air suspension will automatically raise your height by GPS in places that you have, well, using the GPS in places that you have previously raised the suspension of the car, it will raise it back to that same height when you approach the area the next time. So in this particular location, I've raised it for the height of the driveway so I don't scrape. And there you go, you get a message that's raising suspension based on location. And you can see that I last selected very high. So to undo this setting, if I don't want it to raise up here anymore, I can pick another height, or I can remove the pin for the auto raising location. And then once you hit 30 miles an hour or so, well, depends on your car, anywhere from 30 to 36 miles an hour, it will lower back to the lowered setting. Unless you have it set to never lower, then it will just go back to either standard or, it'll just go back to standard, regardless of your car. The Tesla Model S and Model X can be and currently are equipped from the factory with the Smart Air suspension. So with the Smart Air suspension, you can change the heights of the vehicle. So with the Smart Air suspension, you can pick a variety of heights for the vehicle. So we're going to start with very low, and then we're going to work our way up to very high, and then back down to very low, so that you can see what happens. Okay, so you can see the pictorial of the car lowering on the screen. And depending on how the microphone is set, you might be able to hear it gassing out. Probably not. All right, so now we're going to set up with the another camera, and I'm going to go through the various modes for you. Okay, so here we've got the vehicle in the very low setting. Next, we're going to move it to low. Okay, this is low. This is standard. Something to remember about the previous setting, low, is that that is actually where you'll keep it to help minimize the what we call shudder. It's a drivetrain flaw that when you go to accelerate will make a grinding noise on the front half shafts. This is high. There we go, it's completed. It's still spinning though. Ah, there we go, it feels happy now. This is very high. This is as high as the vehicle will go under normal circumstances. At this point, I could enter jack mode if I wanted to, and now it will stop trying to auto-level itself. You'll do that if you want to pick the car up to change the tire. We're going to take it back out of jack mode. And this is at very high. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to take it down to very low. Oh, the Model S only has low through very high. It does not have the very low setting. Going down. And you see the car kind of does it in steps. When it goes up, it tends to pick up the rear first and then the front. And it kind of steps its way over there. When in the very low setting, you need to be very mindful of your surroundings so that you don't scrape the car on anything. It's recommended that you use this on, say, the freeway, a good, smooth, well-maintained freeway, or the racetrack or the drag strip. That's where you get the best results with this. This is also where you can get the most power out of the car. If you're in standard mode, power will be reduced because of the shutter situation I told you about. I'll try to make a separate video on shutter. This car actually has it,
And so I should be able to record it one day when I have more time. All right, so with this, we're going to move the car back up to low. This is where I drive every day. Most of the Model X's actually come delivered locked into this low position, again, to help with the shutter. If you're going to tow with your Model X, then it needs to be on standard, which is this height right here, per the manual. We'll have a whole host of videos coming up on towing whenever I get around to it. I've never actually towed anything, but this car is equipped for towing. I take that back. I did tow some stuff with the lawn tractor at my dad's house when I was a kid, but that doesn't really apply. All right. And with that, I'd like to thank you for watching this video. I'd like to ask you to give it a thumbs up or a like. I'll ask you to subscribe and ring that bell. I'll catch you on the flip side. Thank you. Back very low.